Do you struggle with positioning objects accurately in Blender? Do you spend hours trying to get everything aligned perfectly? Well, fear not, because in this tutorial, we're going to show you how to snap objects with lightning speed and precision. With Blender's snapping tool, you can snap objects together faster than a speeding bullet. From vertices to edges to faces, there's no limit to what you can snap. And the best part? With snapping, you can align your objects with surgical precision. So what are you waiting for? Join the snapping revolution and take your Blender skills to the next level. What is snapping? Snapping in Blender refers to the ability to precisely position objects, vertices, edges, or faces in the 3D space by snapping them to a grid, another object, or a specific point. This feature is particularly useful for aligning objects or creating symmetrical shapes. To enable snapping in Blender, you can click on the magnet icon located at the top of the viewport or press the Shift plus Tab shortcut key. Blender provides 8 distinct snapping modes, each with its unique application. These modes can be accessed by clicking on the Snap Modes icon located at the top of the interface or by using the convenient shortcut key Shift Control Tab. The first one we are going to see is the Increment Snapping. With snapping turned off, if you press G to move, you can observe that the cube is moving in a fluid, smooth manner. But if you turn on Increment Snapping, you can see the cube snaps to the grid points. In simple words, Increment Snapping is a type of snapping in Blender that allows you to move or rotate objects in fixed increments. This Increment Snapping basically works on the viewport grid as you see. If you zoom in a little bit, you can see new grid lines appear on the grid plane. Now, you can move your cube much more precisely and in small increments. You can also achieve this result by altering the unit's scale by getting into the scene properties. Here, as you change the unit scale, you can see the grid become smaller and larger. Now, if you take a look at the Snap Mode menu, you are able to find one option called Absolute Grid Snap. Ever wondered what this feature will do? To understand this, I moved the cube without snapping slightly upward so that the cube will not be in sync with the grid. Now, if we try to move the cube, you can see it does move in the increments, but you can't move it in sync with the grid. That's when the absolute grid snap comes into play. Turning this on will snap the object right back in sync with the grid. Next, we will explore the concept of vertex snapping. As the name implies, vertex snapping aligns selected objects with the vertices of the target object. This feature doesn't work the other way around, that is, by snapping the vertices of the selected objects to the target object. Much like this, the edge snapping does exactly the same. It snaps the selected object to the edges of the other object. To better visualize this process, we can switch to wireframe view, which provides an X-ray-like perspective in Blender. This allows for a clearer understanding of the snapping process. Following that, we'll see face project mode that enables you to snap the vertices of a chosen object onto the surface of a target object. Additionally, we will examine the face nearest mode, which at first glance may seem similar to face project mode. So what makes these two different from one another? In face project mode, the selected object snaps directly onto the face of the target object. On the other hand, in face nearest mode, the selected object snaps onto the nearest face of the target object, even if it is not directly facing the camera. This means that you can snap objects onto occluded geometry, or the opposite side of the target object from the current field of view. Furthermore, in face nearest mode, you can only move the selected object within the boundaries of the target object. You kinda rarely use the last three snapping methods, but it wouldn't hurt to learn those too. The sixth snapping mode is called volume snapping. Suppose if you want to move this cube within this sphere for some reason. If you do it by manually moving the cube, you will have to move it in all three axes all by yourself. But if you turn on volume snapping, you can fully insert this cube into the sphere, just like that. The edge center snapping mode explains itself. The object will snap to the center point of the edge of the target object that is closest to the mouse cursor. The last one is called edge perpendicular. It snaps to a precise point on the edge, ensuring that the line connecting its original location, which is marked by a white cross, and its new location is perpendicular to the edge. And there you have it, a complete overview of the different snapping modes in Blender. Each mode has its own strengths and can be a valuable asset to your workflow. We will see the rest of the snapping tool in the next video. Mastering snapping in Blender can save your time, effort, and frustration. So, start experimenting with different snapping modes. Find what works best for your project and take your 3D modeling and animation to the next level. In the meantime, try watching our video explaining pivot points, and don't forget to share and subscribe to the channel for further Blender tutorials. Until then, happy blending!